Hey there guys, it's your favorite backyard geographer out in the field here at California's fifth largest lake, Mono Lake, California. Join me today as I discover the lake itself, the geologic history, these incredible features that are behind me, the Tufa Towers, and a little bit more. Let's go. So our volcanic history begins about 760,000 years ago after the massive eruption here in Mono County. So we're sitting pretty much off center with this massive caldera that erupted out here. So after the late Pleistocene, when all the snow and glacial melt was occurring, this lake itself, it was about 1,100 feet deeper than it is today. You're probably wondering, well, why is it so low then? And it's quite an interesting story. It was actually a terminal lake until it overfilled. And what I mean by that is that a terminal lake doesn't have any outlets, but it became so full that it began to spill over. And it's called the spillover theory, in which this lake spilled over into Crawley and worked its way down to Owens, and then eventually ended up in Lake Manly, which is Death Valley. So we gotta talk about the Tufa Towers. It's one of the most iconic things here at the lake. So tufa is really, really unique. It's a calcium carbonate that's created. We have a lot of snow melt that occurs around the entire valley itself, and that water is slowly absorbed within the mountains, within the soil, and it pushes down. When it pushes down, it's able to create freshwater springs. But because of that, they're gonna be calcium rich. So as the water is being pushed down around us, it's being thrusted up underneath us. So in doing so, when it's meeting this alkali lake, it's creating these jets of mineral-rich of water that's essentially precipitating this type of rock. So that means these tufa had to have been completely submerged in order to develop. I bring that up because I don't know if you're going to be able to see behind me, but right here is a great tower, and you can actually see the different layers or flatness of the lake levels through its past. I would say probably about the halfway point would have been the same lake level that this lake would have been at in the 1960s. So how big is Mono Lake? It's about 19 miles by 9 miles, and on averaging about 57 feet deep. But in the center, it's over 150 feet in depth. All right, so let's go back. Lake Russell, that's what this was. After the eruption, filled with glacial melt, massive freshwater lake. What's interesting about that is that as the water began to evaporate and drain out, water can evaporate, but the minerals that are left behind get stuck. Kind of like if you boil water and you forget about it and you come back and there's white minerals that are in the bottom of the pan. That's what happened here. So in fact, this lake that we see here has over 280 million tons of salt in it alone, which makes it over almost two times as salty as the ocean itself. All right, so we've established it's salty, but what could possibly survive in an environment like this? There are two really, really important things that thrive in this environment. One are the brine flies, and the second are what I like to call sea monkeys, which are the brine shrimp that live in this lake. They're really important, especially for this ecohabitat, because over 35 different species of migratory birds stay here just to eat those insects and to thrive. That's unique. But what's even better about that is that those brine fly larvae, when the Mono people were really prominent in this region, that's what they lived off of as well. So now we're out here on the beach, and I want to kind of speak about the geology that we stand facing. So this material is pretty chunky. It's really large clasts, but what is it? Well, it's a mix of a couple things. It's gonna be some of the local geology that's kind of drained in through just normal erosion, transportation, deposition. But some of these larger clasts are actually tufa. There's also volcanic ash. Why? Because not just from this location, the entire Mono area is surrounded by volcanoes. In fact, the most recent eruption was about 700 years ago at Panem Crater. Thank you. So there's signs everywhere asking you not to climb, don't touch, don't get near these towers, because the oils in your hands, the acidity in the precipitation is actually causing them to dissolve. So every time I've come out here, they've become a little browner and a little darker, which is kind of sad, because you're seeing that as time progresses and because of climatic change, that we're seeing a dramatic change in the tufa towers here along the south edge of Mono Lake. So one of the last things I want to mention, just because I think it's interesting, is that we've mentioned volcanism, we've mentioned water, we've mentioned ice and water, you know, all kinds of things. One thing I want to add is that we're part of the Great Basin region, and because of that, we're also seeing crustal stretching, which is really neat, because what ends up happening, kind of like a rubber band, when you start pulling on either side of a rubber band, the rubber band itself becomes thinner, and in doing so, so does the crust in this location. So that is why we see evidence of a lot of geothermal activity around this area. In fact, there's some great locations to visit, but there's a geothermal energy plant not that far from here as well that takes the energy from the earth to power the world that we live in today. Well, I hope that you got to enjoy the fact that we were here at Mono Lake on a day that there is no wind. It is absolutely beautiful and stunning. This is an iconic piece of California history and culture, and it's been such a great experience again for us today. Don't forget to click like, subscribe, and we'll talk soon. So our story begins about 776,000. Sorry, that was a hard number to say. One more time. So our volcanic journey, guess why? After a massive eruption here in Mono County, the Mono Lake itself. We're actually in a massive caldera itself. I said itself like three times. So our volcanic history begins about 700. Our volcanic history begins about 707. I don't know why I can't.